यस, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल प्लीज रीड द क्वेश्चन केयरफुली. वंस यू आर डन, राइट इन द कमेंट बॉक्स यस सर डन. आई एम वेटिंग फॉर योर रेस्पॉन्सेस. ओके, नाउ लिसन केयरफुली. डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू स्टेशन इज 936. ऑल राइट, 936. टू ट्रेन स्टार्ट फ्रॉम स्टेशन ए एंड बी एट द सेम टाइम इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन. दिस इज स्टेशन ए, दिस इज स्टेशन बी. टू ट्रेन स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हेयर एंड फ्रॉम वन इज फ्रॉम हेयर एट द सेम टाइम. ओके, स्पीड ऑफ फर्स्ट ट्रेन इंक्रीजेज 1 किलोमीटर पर आवर इन ईच आवर एंड स्पीड ऑफ सेकेंड ट्रेन डिक्रीजेज बाय 1 किलोमीटर पर आवर इन ईच आवर. इफ स्पीड ऑफ बोथ ट्रेन आर 32 किलोमीटर पर आवर एंड 46 किलोमीटर पर आवर. इफ दे स्टार्ट रनिंग एट 5 PM, ओके, स्टार्ट रनिंग एट 5 PM, एट वट टाइम बोथ विल मीट. गाइज बिलीव मी, दिस इज वेरी इजी एंड ऑर्डिनरी क्वेश्चन. This is very easy and ordinary question. In this question, you have been given that one train is increasing its speed by 1 kilometer per hour in each hour, and one train is decreasing in each hour. Then this increase and this decrease will cancel out. This increase and this decrease will cancel out. So this line will not affect the answer of the question. So now this question is very, very, very simple. You have to find the time. Time is equal to distance upon speed. Distance is 936. Speed is what? 78. That means after 12 hours, both train will meet. And if they started at 5 p.m., then after 12 hours, that is at 5 a.m., they will meet again. They will meet each other. So guys, these two lines are in the question just to puzzle you. They does not make any sense. Because one train is increasing its speed, one train is decreasing its speed. So this increase and this decrease will cancel out. Then this will not affect the answer of the question. This is very, very, very interesting question, guys. Yes. No, Avinash and Sai Kumar. If the increase and decrease are different, then this will take time. And this will not be asked in your examination of RRB NTPC exam. Okay, if increase and decrease are not same, then this will not be asked in your examination. Okay, this will go to the higher level, so you need not to worry about it. Okay, is this clear to all of you? Now let's move to the next question. So guys, this question you can easily do. There is no any problem. This question you can easily do. There is no any problem. Length of train is 300 meter. Speed of train is 72 kilometer per hour. In how much time train will cross standing man? Yes guys, please try to give the answer in the comment box. This type of question I have already done. This type of question I have already taught you. Yeah, very good. So we have to find the time. Time is equal to distance upon speed. When a train is crossing a standing man, then it will cover its speed, its distance. And speed is 72 kilometer per hour. I have to convert this in meter per second. That is 15 seconds answer. Is this question is clear to all of you? Yes or no, write in the comment box. Then I will give you the next question. Yes guys, so I am giving you a question, please try to solve that question. Okay, I am writing the question here. If a train if just a second if train A crosses a pole in 10 seconds and train B crosses a ball in 15 seconds. Then, in how much time they will cross each other? In how much time they will cross each other? Yes, this is the question. Yes, guys, please try to solve the question and give the answer in the comment box. Train A crosses a pole in 10 seconds. Train B crosses a pole in 15 seconds. In how much time they will cross each other? So in these type of question, always apply the formula concept of time and work. Now, please, first train is crossing in 10 seconds. Second train is crossing in 15 seconds. So this is the time. I'm taking the LCM of these two, that is 30. This is distance. Distance upon time is speed. This is 3, this is 2, and this is 5, because I'm writing the extra information here. Just a second. Cross each other in opposite direction. In opposite direction. Okay. All right. Yes, this is the question. Guys, whenever you are having the question of this type, always apply the time and work concept. First train is taking 10 seconds, second train is taking 15 seconds. Distance is 30, distance upon time is speed, 3, 2, that is 5. I'm adding the speeds because they are running in the opposite direction. Then time, okay, this is the length of each train. Okay, just a second, guys, I'm writing the one extra information in this question. And length of each train, length of both trains are equal. Now the question is okay. This is the question. Now I will explain you again, don't worry. If train A crosses a pole in 30 seconds, okay, 10 seconds, and train B crosses the pole in 15 seconds, then in how much time they will cross each other in opposite direction and length of trains are equal? This is given in the question. Okay, this is the information. So in this you don't have any doubt, I think. Now this is the length of each train, because whenever a train is crossing a pole, it will cross its height, its length. So length of each train is 30 seconds. Okay, now we have to find in how much time they will cross each other. Okay, when they cross each other, they have to cross the sum of their lengths. That means time is equal to distance upon speed. So distance is what? 30 plus 30. In order to cross each other, they have to cross the sum of their speed lengths with the speed 5. That is 60 by 5. That is 12 seconds. That means they will cross each other in 12 seconds. They will cross each other in 12 seconds. Why I am adding 32 times? Because I'm adding the length of both the trains. I think this is clear to all of you. Yes or no? Write in the comment box. Maninganta, okay, I will tell you, don't worry. I'm giving you the next question. If two trains of equal lengths are crossing a pole in 10 seconds and 15 seconds respectively, okay, then in how much time fastest train will cross first train will cross the slower train in the same direction. That is, if the train of lengths are unequal, then train of lengths will be given to you. Okay, now listen carefully. If two trains of equal length are crossing a pole in 10 seconds and 15 seconds, respectively, in how much time faster train will cross the slower train in the same direction? Yes, guys, please try to give the answer. This is the time, and we are taking the distance. Distance is, you can say, length. Okay, and this is 3, this is 2, and this is speed. This is 5. Now, we have to find the time when faster train will cross the, in how much time faster train will cross the slower train. Now, listen, guys, carefully. Guys, I have already told you, when the train 1 and train 2, when train 2 is crossing train 1 in the same direction, then train 2 has to cover the sum of the distances of these two trains. Alright? So, length of one train is 30, then length of two trains is 30 plus 30 divided by, as the both trains are going in the same direction, then speed will be subtracted. Rate of speed should be 1. So this is 60 seconds. That means faster train will cross the slower train in 60 seconds. Yes, guys, is this clear to all of you? Yes or no? Yes, can I have the responses, please? Someone is asking when they are running in the same direction, so I made the question in the same direction. Okay. Okay. Now, so guys, this is all about time, speed, distance and train topic. This is all about time, speed, distance and train topic. Then I will start boat and stream topic in the next class. This is very easy topic. I will start boat and stream topic in the next